Hey, if you struggle with making sense of your ideas and your thoughts, this video I think you are really going to enjoy. So today we're gonna dive into the process of how I took my thoughts and ideas from a single note and visually turned it into several atomic notes using the app Heptabase. Now, before we get started, I do have a gift for you. This is my free guide on how to take book notes and get those insights and ideas and thoughts into your personal knowledge management system. And all this is without using Readwise. All right, so it's a methodical approach that has worked for me over the years, and I want to share it with you. So by the end of the guide, you will have a simple system for highlighting books, a mindful approach for adding content to your second brain, or PKM, and then a process for creating building blocks of knowledge for the future, and then also a simple way to make more connections inside of your personal knowledge management system. I'll leave the link in the description below for you if you want to check that out. A personal example here of how I am using the whiteboard and Heptabase and the cards and journal and all that stuff. So recently I was listening to a podcast about the history of Legos. Real cool history kids podcast or something like that. So it's meant for kids, but I was listening to it with my kids. Listening to it about the history of Legos. And I started to, in my journal, I started to note whenever I had something that stood out to me, I was writing down things that I thought were cool. So like one of them was like, Lego is from two Danish words that mean play well. That's just a cool thought. Another one was Lego in Latin means to play. No, means I put together. Another one was it's still owned by the same family who started it. Right, so I was jotting down all these just cool little nuggets while I was listening to the podcast, and this was all inside of the journal. And what I did was I took all of the notes, I highlighted all of them, and then I used the turn into card feature, okay? And it turned it into a card for me. And then when I was looking at the card, I started noticing some things that stood out to me, and I wanted to pull those out in a whiteboard. So let me go to the whiteboard real quick. This is the history of Legos. This is where it kind of started right here, okay? So I titled this note, A Timeless Creation That Naturally Develops Creativity, because Legos, after listening to it, is one of those toys that is just continued to be sold over and over again. It's one of the highest requested toys, and they were talking about why. It's because Legos, it naturally develops your creativity. So I was just really intrigued by that, and I thought, I need to kind of think about this some more. So all these notes that I took here, I was started to kind of tease out a little bit, right? So one of them was, why are Legos so popular? So I had more notes down here, but I turned it into its own card and drew an arrow to this, indicating that, you know, this is something else that I was thinking about and that stood out to me while listening to the podcast. And this led to a thought for me that I need to engage with toys and tools that stimulate my brain and cultivate creativity, which was ended up being like a little insight right here. And I added an image of Legos just for the fun of it. Something that they mentioned that I wanted to explore a little bit further regarding why are Legos so popular, again, having to do with creativity, is the fact that it's related to divergent thinking, the power of unstructured problem solving. And so I wanted to think about that a little bit further. And there's an article here that I was looking at, and while looking at it, I made a highlight with the Chrome extension, the Readwise Chrome extension, which then I ended up adding to this note right here, right? So basically I can hit the at symbol, and I'll start typing this, let's see, thinking divergently. Let's see if it comes up. Thinking divergently right here under highlights. This is exactly what I did. I already had it in my highlights because I highlighted it with the Chrome extension. Then I just simply attached it to this card. Now, this is a card. This is a card. This is a card. All these are individual cards. And all these cards are atomic notes that can all have metadata inside of them, right? I can add tags if I wanted to. I barely have scratched the surface right here. Another thought that I had, PKM, the Legos of knowledge. You can build entire thought cities and monuments by connecting ideas together with like these whiteboard apps like this, right? It's just a cool thought because the Legos, you're building something, you're with these little tiny pieces, and the Legos are the atomic thoughts, and you can build entire cities. I watched a video recently when I was learning about the Legos, about how this guy literally built this whole city from one of the Harry Potter scenes or something like that. It was like a whole, it was insane the detail that he put into it. Down to the little creatures inside of these cages, and it was just awesome to see. And that's when I had this thought of the cities, that these thought cities and monuments. Anyway, so this is an example here, a small example. I think I'm going to go into more examples in other videos, but this is a small example of me listening to and consuming information, putting it in my journal, turning that into a card, taking that card, putting it onto a whiteboard, and then teasing out the card into multiple cards, multiple atomic notes.